airplane of the 50s, a weapon developed in the 70s, brought together in the 80s to create a new strategic weapons system, the air-launched cruise missile. The first B-52 cruise missile squadron will become operational at Griffiss Air Force Base, New York, in December 1982. Lieutenant Colonel Howard Bush, Cruise Missile Task Force, explains.
The purpose of the cruise missile is to enhance the air-breathing leg of the triad. These great numbers of cruise missiles added to the triad will dilute enemy defenses. Once the cruise missile leaves the aircraft, the control surfaces are deployed, the engine is started, and it transitions from battery power to its own internal generator power. At that time, the cruise missile then flies to cruise stored positions within its computer memory.
For the B-52 air crews, the cruise missile means more responsibility and increased training. Lieutenant Colonel John Klink, Chief Operations Division for the 416th Bomb Wing.
The part task trainer does about everything that the airplane does. The crew member can come into the part task trainer and actually go through all the steps required for him to launch the cruise missile identical to those on the aircraft. This trainer was the first one developed, arrived here in Griffiss in April of this year, which allowed us to convert almost the entire crew force to the cruise missile.
The cruise missile required several new maintenance advancements. Airman First Class Ronald Bowden, Missile Systems Analyst.
In order to move the cruise missile inside the intermediate maintenance facility, we used the monorail hoist. Now this monorail hoist, in conjunction with the missile hoisting beam, can lift the cruise missile and move it throughout the maintenance facility, and can also move the short-range attack missile.
The cruise missile posed numerous challenges to Air Force maintenance crews. It required the development of a specialized pylon, which carries six cruise missiles. A remotely controlled trailer was also developed to lift, support, and load the pylon missile combination, a total of 24,000 pounds. It's people working together that make the air-launched cruise missile a successful new weapon. Captain Bill Percival, B-52 pilot.
The integration of the cruise missile here at Griffiss has been a major wing-level project. It's involved work by operations, maintenance, and security police people, as well as other units on the base. It's been a project that we've been working on now for 2 years, and we're really looking forward to operational capability at the end of this year.